Bonjour tout le monde. Merci Jenica pour tes mots, mais aussi pour d'être une représentante extraordinaire pour cette communauté. Merci aussi à Dominique et Ginette qui soignent à nous. Je suis très heureux d'être avec vous aujourd'hui au Nouveau-Brunswick. I'm also glad that we can have partners from internet providers here today for this important announcement. Our government is focused on building an economy that works for all Canadians. That includes people living in rural and remote areas. In order to fully participate in the economy, you need to have reliable, high-speed internet. In the 21st century, connectivity is incredibly important. It means grandparents can have video calls with grandkids who live far away. It allows small businesses to connect with customers across the street, across the country, and around the world. And it's essential for both work and learning. Since 2019, we've been making transformative investments to connect communities across Canada through the Universal Broadband Fund. Our goal is to connect every community in every province and territory to high-speed internet. We have a plan to connect 98% of Canadians by 2026, and we're on track to beat that goal ahead of time. To make sure we keep up momentum, today we're announcing a major investment of almost $500 million, which will connect an additional 60,000 rural homes across Canada. Ici au Nouveau-Brunswick, on fournit des fonds supplémentaires pour brancher plus de 27 000 foyers, y compris dans les communautés autochtones et rurales. Certaines de ces communautés sont situées près d'ici, comme Lakeville Corner and Swan Creek. Here in New Brunswick, the federal plan will connect 99.7% of households in the coming years, with the province working to cover the final 0.3% of hardest places to reach. Like I said, we're building an economy that works for all Canadians, and that means no matter where you live, you can be a full part of Canada's growing economy and benefit from the opportunities that lie ahead. On sait qu'à cause de l'inflation mondiale, c'est difficile pour bien des familles de payer les factures. C'est pour ça que notre gouvernement est là pour aider la classe moyenne et ceux qui travaillent fort pour en faire partie. On Internet, we're ensuring that the most vulnerable families and seniors have access to affordable, low-cost internet at $10 to $20. We doubled the GST credit for 6 months, which means hundreds of dollars of support for 11 million households. So if you just saw a few hundred dollars appear in your bank account over the weekend, it's because we delivered on that GST credit with help to pay your groceries, to pay your rent, to pay various things as the costs go up. We're also moving forward with legislation to make sure families can afford dental care for kids under 12 and to provide hundreds of dollars of additional support for low-income renters. Our fall economic statement also laid out our plan to permanently eliminate interest payments on Canada's student and apprenticeship loans and lower credit card fees for small businesses. See, with our approach, we're creating jobs and careers today and opportunities for all Canadians into the future. Making sure everyone is connected to high-speed internet is an important part of our plan. Our government will continue working with partners, whether in other orders of government or in the private sector, to make sure that we continue to bring more Canadians online. En étant plus connectés et en travaillant tous ensemble, on est capable de relever tous les défis qui nous attendent.